Welcome everyone, and thank you for joining me today to listen to my lecture.
As the topic "How low can we go? Unite in future settings" indicates, our research group investigated how deep learning networks work with little data efficiently. To start off, in medical imaging we have the notorious problem of having only few samples of similar pathologies available. However, fortunately the human body is very prototypical. That is, when we use X-ray or MR imaging, we have only little variation in perspective for selected diseases. But before we move any further, I want to introduce the main research topic the work is based on. The University Hospital of Essen provided X-ray and MRI data of patients with necrotic femur. The investigation of the images is time-consuming and dependent on the doctor and his or her shape on the day. Therefore, we have made an effort to automate the process of diagnostic analysis. But unfortunately, the necrosis isn't visible on the X-ray images the doctor is using while diagnosing in surgery. So the main difference of X-ray and MRI data for the questioning of femur investigation is that X-ray has a higher resolution, whereas MRI is more specific about several sections of the body. So we have tried to merge specific characteristics of the MRI into the high detailed X-ray images. One project challenge was to segment the X-ray femur, but the completion of this task only expanded the questioning. If we can work successfully with our about 35 images for training and validation, how low can we go? Let's find out. Our dataset is divided into training, validation and test set, but instead of initializing unit feeding with the whole dataset, we only use a few samples. We train our model until convergence and use the generated model as initial starting point for further steps. Here we enrich our training and validation set with few samples and restart training. Wait until convergence, and so on, until all data sets are used. And in the end, we can assess our models in comparison to the standard unit procedure. Our findings are promising. For the anterior-posterior view on the left, only 10 samples resulted in about 98% accuracy, and for the more stable inputs, in Lonsdale view on the right, only 8 samples are sufficient for similar results. Compared to standard unit, our implementation needed less images in training and validation for our reliable results. Our segmentation quality increases faster and is stable on a higher level. For each number of images, our overfitting architecture needed less image iterations for convergence compared to the standard unit feeding. Nevertheless, so far gradual overfitting has been poorly explored. Thus, we need more research addressing refining parameters by overfitting on medical images. But to close up, our training process completed faster with even better results compared to the standard unit feeding, and we are looking forward to future research with regard to our idea. Thank you for making it to the end, and I hope to meet you in person next year at the BBM workshops.